The numbers have dropped. So if you take a look at producer price index on a month-on-month basis, if you back out food, you back out energy, down by 0.1%. On a year-on-year basis, still holding, but down sequentially, coming in at 2.1%. That missed expectations and also lower than that June reading. And the final demand, though, holding steady, coming in at 1.7%. So a lot of things going into this, obviously going to be somewhat of a number that's movable. You have oil had an insane month as well. But nonetheless, you see that a producer price index, you back out food, you back out energy on a month-on-month basis, down by 0.1%. Mike McKee is joining us, Bloomberg National Economics and Policy Correspondent. Amy Wilson-Silverman of RBC Capital Markets and Jim Paulson of the Lothfeld Group are still with us. Mike, what is your first blush read on this?
Well, it comes in pretty much as expected, and we're not seeing anything unusual in the breakdown of how things fall out here. Food prices were up 0.2, a little bit of a surprise, and then people who are looking at oil prices today would be surprised, but energy was up 2.3%. That was prior to the big drop-off. This was back in July. Trade up 0.2%, not a big deal there. Transportation and warehousing, which had been affected by tariffs, up 0.2 as well. Where we're seeing some declines, though, services, and that's kind of interesting because people have been counting on service industry inflation to try to boost the overall inflation rate. They're down 0.1%. I'm not seeing anything too exciting in the overall breakdown of bit by bit here. I'm looking for steel, not seeing it off the top of my head, but steel prices had been rolling over, and that's one thing we wanted to keep track of because, of course, the steel tariffs have made a big difference in prices to producers there. So it doesn't really tell us a whole lot about where we're going in the sense that PPI doesn't feed directly into CPI or PCE, but it gives you sort of a general view of where we are. We are not creating a whole lot of inflation at the moment. The good news, alcohol prices down.
But just surprising, because I feel like I really did my part.
Those who are going out on demand perspective. On vacation, I've got some good news for you.